Oh boy. I keep telling y'all, watch my videos all the way through before comment. And it came to my surprise earlier during this day, that a sister, that is a subscriber, she a subscriber to my channel, she commented on how another sister probably didn't watch my video all the way through. And I think she didn't, because the way she wrote in that little paragraph in my comment thread, that shows me the indication that she didn't get it. I thank you, sister, for coming in my defense and upholding your king. And I respect you. Love, peace, and happiness to your kids that has grown. Then you said you had one kid that was still a teenager. You're a strong, good sister. And it seems like you're eloquent. It seems like you're well-educated and well-learned, and you talk. You talk very intellectual. I appreciate that video. I went to the channel and took my pleasure in watching your video, and you made some valid points. You gotta bear with me. I'm smoking this cigar, trying to keep these little pestilence from biting me. It's very humid where I'm at now. We didn't have a heat wave, and it's the humidity and the heat is whew. But that's life. That's summer. I don't care. I love nature. Hot, cold, whatever the season is. God made this earth. He do what he want to do. He do what he want to do. I don't question his will. But anyway, people don't realize I'm not trying to hurt black men. I'm not trying to hurt, bash either side of the track. I'm trying to educate y'all on a higher level, because I see a lot of hate on social media when it comes to us as a race, and it's only getting worse. It's not even getting any better. So although while we keep going in this circle of events, we act like we don't even appreciate the life we live in these days. I can't understand it sometimes, how we keep going this way. And there's a lot of people with time on their hands. You know, once you see a whole page of videos with the same date, the same day, like 20 videos made or 30 videos. Some of these people, I ain't saying all, they don't got nothing to do with their lives. Who want to hear misery all day? Who want to keep on hearing about the black man ain't doing this, the black woman ain't doing this, the black man is the destruction of the black community, the black woman is the destruction of the black community? Okay, we know this. It's time to move on to other bigger and better things. How are we going to change it? Don't y'all see that this thing has always been spiritual? Don't you see that by y'all doing this, it only makes it worse for both sides of the gender? I think y'all blind. I think y'all can see, but y'all blind in y'all mind. Your brain is suffocating. It cannot breathe out knowledge because it's being suffocated by mental slavery of such. I love my sisters. I love my brothers. I love my melanated race. I always will. I always will. No question about it. But y'all sit in y'all little comfort zones, thinking it's all fine and dandy to keep ridiculing your own race while other races are still waxing rich in your communities. Why you black man cry about weeds? You know, one of my nieces by marriage, then she owned 2 hair salons. That's right, black women. She owned 2 hair salons. That's right. Black men, if you got entrepreneurial skills and ownership of businesses, of running businesses such as places like that, go own your weave shop and sell the weave to your women instead of complaining about women wearing weave. Make some money off of it. See, we keep crying about the problem, but we never get to the solution and get out and get the ball rolling. Economically, I see a lot of bashing. I see a lot of hate. I see a lot of confusion on the internet, and it's getting worse day, and it's been going on for years, but it's coming to a head. I got a racist comment in my comment thread. Some guy called me a jigaboo and nigger, KKK, and all this. Look, man, ignorance is something I love to hate. You don't want to learn, it's something I love to hate. You don't want to prove yourself, it's something I love to hate. All these things is destroying the fabric of black folks. It's destroying the infrastructure. I don't know how plain I can make this shit, okay? I've been on the other side of the fence. I've been in rough situations. I've been violent. I was a hooligan, a thug, and all that shit y'all talking about. I know what these youngins going through, but it's 10 times worse than that. And by the older people like me, the middle-aged men and the elders and the middle-aged women and the elder women, y'all making it worse because y'all acting like children. Y'all immature. Y'all talking about dumb shit day in and day out. Then y'all clickbaiting and using other people as your catalyst and your platform to talk about, to get views, because they're prominent YouTubers and your channels are low seated, low numbered. You don't have many subscribers. Enough. I've been on here for a minute. Okay? It took me some time to figure out the Negro sector. Now I see what's going on. You got the Hotep community. They got their little beefing going on. Pro-blacks, what have you. Just your whole conscious community. Then you got your clowns, your trolls. Then you got your feminists. Then you got your Meg tiles. And then you got your women tiles, or whatever they, women want to go their own, black women want to go their own way. Something like that. And I'm gonna tell you something about that. It's destroying the family unit. It's destroying wife, husband, children. By y'all separating and detaching yourself from the family unit, that's destroying the whole black race. And that's what the devil wants. And y'all playing right into the spider web of deception. Y'all don't get it. Y'all do not get it. What's wrong with y'all? Y'all sleeping in a bed of concrete because y'all hard-headed. Y'all laying on concrete with no mattress, with no box spring, with no mattress. You land straight on a concrete block because y'all hard headed. Hard-headed people, man. You see what's going on in Milwaukee. You think that's going to stop? It's not going to stop. Now, I heard some stuff from that. I done a video about that. I'm going to elaborate more on that. Heard some more news footage on that. Don't you know that area is below the poverty line? Don't you know those people are suffering in that state as we speak? The school systems is messed up. They said the kids are uneducated, the adults are uneducated. So if you got that going on up in Milwaukee, that was just a nail in the coffin when they done that to that man. It's waiting for an explosion. It's waiting for an uproar and an upheaval. All I see, folks, is this country going into an internal inferno. It's going to destroy itself within. And another civil war and a race war. That's all I see. And y'all don't want this because no one is going to win. It's going to be the worst war of the man. Y'all don't want that. Y'all don't. I don't even want that. It's not about me being a coward, a sucker, a punk, a bitch, because I'm none of that. I'm going to tell you, y'all don't want that. That means your comfort zones, your jobs, your pursuit of happiness, the ones that made it, you know, that's living somewhat good in this American society as black folks gonna go down the shit tubes. Your families ain't gonna be safe. Your security ain't gonna be safe. Your bank accounts ain't gonna be safe. Y'all screaming martial law. Martial law means destruction of all your civil liberties. That means the military is up in your house. Screwing your wife, might even screw your man too. Y'all don't want this. I don't want this. But y'all keep on black men and black women. Now, no side is right. No side is right. Everything is wrong when it comes to this. Then you got people, because something happened to them, they want to take it out on both sexes. Something that happened in a personal life. You can't do that. You can't drag your race all up under the bus because something happened to you. Life ain't perfect. I hate to say it, people. It's not. You will face obstacles if you don't do the right things according to the laws and the oaths of spirituality. If you live in demonic, well, that's all you're going to get in return. Drugs. Like this. I do this in moderation. I don't do this. I do this every blue moon. One thing I was told a long time ago. If you do anything like alcohol or smoking. I ain't talking about drugs. But that's drugs too. If you do that too much, then you have addiction. It's like eating. It's like gluttony. It's like you can't get enough sex. You're a nymphomaniac. All this. Anything you do too much, you're addicted. And you make it your God. See? See, these men are making bashing women their religion. These women are making bashing men their religion. It's becoming their God. This is all they know. This is the only way they produce videos. Cause hate. Any other topic, it's like they illiterate. They don't know. Because they have no substance of no publication or nothing. I speak on many issues. And this is going to be the last time I address this gender war shit. Cause I gotta move on to bigger and better things as I progress up on YouTube and do my video. I don't got time for this bullshit. I done told y'all time and time again. This is not going to work for your household. This ain't going to work for your intermediate families. It's not going to work. It's going to bring destruction to the black race. Haven't we suffered enough? I done told y'all about the atrocities. I don't need to go over that. Y'all know it. It's up on the internet. They've done everything conceivable to us as a black race. Tortured, done, had their way with us. Now we acting like we hate ourselves. Now we got these people talking about dark skin. It's not appealing. I love me some blue black women. The blacker the better. And the sister who defended me was a dark skin sister. Then I went and seen her video. She's a beautiful sister. Beautiful. Fine is all out wine. Yes. Very educated. And gave some of her personal achievements. And congratulations. Stay strong, sis. That's what we need. But y'all brothers won't do videos about that. Y'all won't. Y'all focus on the ratchets, the ones that come from dysfunctional homes. What the fuck do you expect? If the mama a hoe, trick, ratchet, it's only right for her daughters. Cause the daughters sponge off the mother. Come on, brothers. Use your logic. Where's your common sense? Y'all have none. But y'all get up on here acting like y'all articulate, intellectual. Ah, I'm the all-knowing. I'm the all-present. Man, get the fuck out of here. You throw all your logic and your credibility out the window when you do multiple videos dedicating it to men's channels like me and bashing me and bashing women. Y'all have no credibility. And y'all women, y'all doing the same thing. Some of y'all women, I keep telling y'all, I'm not talking about all, I'm talking about one, the ones in that category. Some of y'all look at videos and don't comprehend. You gotta read and you gotta understand what you read. You gotta understand the video, you gotta understand the publication. If you can't understand, that means you lack reading, you lack reading comprehension. You lack wisdom, you lack education. Get some learning in your life instead of commenting on something and you're not paying attention to what I was talking about. That's why we need more teachers like me. That's why we need more brothers like me. It's like they don't make men like us no more. They don't make men like us no more because it shows. Prove me wrong, brothers. Send me some feedback if they make men like us. But I think they don't. It's only a faithful few. We are like diamonds in the rough, man. Got guys in the comments section talking about give up. Black woman, she's done. Got black women saying the same thing, calling us demonic. We the cause of this. We not standing up. Well, I blame that on the destruction, the ongoing legacy on the destruction of the family unit. There's no spirituality present no more. Everything is material. Chasing the Joneses. You never can get enough. You got a car, house, you can pay your bills. You got a roof over your head, but it's still not enough. You're trying to prove something to somebody else. You're trying to be a big show-off. Instead of helping the less fortunate. Instead of walking with the poor and the downtrodden. Don't you know you get blessed from that? You get blessings from that. You know, I don't look down on people that's less fortunate than me. I never did. I don't poke fun at people that's deformed or retarded or slow. I'm glad I'm a dark-skinned brother. The guy with a beard. I'm happy the way I look. Some of you brothers got low self-esteem. Some of you brothers want to be women. Some of y'all women want to be men. That's half of the problem. Y'all mad because y'all struggling with y'all sexuality. That's a mental problem. If I worried about what people say about me, I never would accomplish nothing. I wouldn't even be on YouTube producing videos if I care about what motherfuckers say about me. I care less. Bad. What people say bad about me, I care less. I have no conscience when it comes to that because I know what they're trying to do. I see people disable their comments. That comes with the heat in the YouTube kitchen. You can't stand it. You might want to get the hell out. Because you're going to always have those that want to get jealous and disgruntled and try to piss and shit on your commentary. You're always going to have that. Because they entrench themselves, they drench themselves with hatred. My Anglo brothers and sisters, some of y'all got to realize black people ain't going nowhere. We didn't ask to come over here. We got much stake and claim in America, just like you do. And it wasn't for us, it wouldn't be no America. Because we built America. We put America on our backs and built this country. Okay? So we just as much or more patriots than the Anglo brothers and sisters. Okay? What's his name? Hussein Bolt? My props go to him. Jamaican brother. The Jamaican sisters doing their thing and track and field, whatever. Gabby Douglas and Mrs. Miles, the two black sisters, young sisters, doing their thing. And we got these disgruntled, asinine, jealous ass black women, jealous of a woman that just got into womanhood, just turned 20. Been fucking with this girl since she was 16 all the way up until now. Talking about her fucking hair and her edges. What in the fuck are we doing, man, in 2016? Are we still in high school? Are we still in junior high? Are we still in middle school or kindergarten? That's little children shit. We got grown people acting like children. And it's a shame. And y'all call yourself college graduates and people of substance and all this. I don't see it. You got men my age acting like fools. Bad parenting. Dysfunctional homes. It all goes back to that. Who was raising these people? Some of y'all want to still embrace these streets. These trap houses still want to kill each other, still want to be jealous of each other. Black men, people are taking over, man. They've been taking over. All these herb stores, I've been hearing y'all talking about these herb-owned stores, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, Latinos in the construction trade because the black contractors don't want to come together and create construction contracting firms or nothing. We don't want to do it. We're too greedy. I got mines, get yours, fuck you, nigga. That's how we is. We don't want to each one teach one no more. We don't. And y'all get on here and cry about the tragedies that take place. Right now, I bet you someone else and fucking bit the dust. Every time I go on social media, it's another tragedy. And people get on their little video channels and fuck the whole commentary up because they use a tragedy to point the finger at their own race. This is why. And all I'm doing, I'm sitting up on here trying to tell y'all it's another way other than that. But you can't convince everybody. You can't change. You can't teach a dog new tricks, you know? Because some of y'all don't want to learn new tricks. Y'all want to stay in ignorance for the rest of y'all lives and wonder why y'all life ain't going nowhere. Misery loves company. King Rasta is a soldier. Always will, always will be. I'm not gonna give up, never will. That's not in my heart. That's not in my constitution of my mind. We at a critical stage now. Got them brothers over in Africa posting their stuff up, got all those women kidnapped. Hacking people up, raping them young women, their own people, because of religious ideology. Don't you know, even Albert Pike talked about this in Morals and Dogma, how Islam gonna be pit against Christianity, vice versa, and all the religions that go with it. It's going to be a calamity of religious strife and turmoil and campaigns to bring on the beast and the Antichrist, the omen, and all this shit. Don't you know that's the plan, to destroy all religion and worship the devil on earth? See, the devil is trying to defeat the Most High. This is the true battle. His spirits with him are running this earth, and his quest is to destroy all religion. He wants you to bow down to him. That's why it's sexual deviancy across the board. This is why it's rape. This is why it's mass murderers running everywhere. Where you think that come from? Where you think? What you think this all these movements against black men, against black women are coming from? That's demonic. Depopulation. Mass incarceration of black men and black women. Black on black crime. Come on, y'all. Put a little love in your heart. Love conquers all, but hate kills all. I had to take time out today to make this video lengthy, because I'm gonna keep on preaching this until YouTube drop down and be dismantled, which I don't think is going nowhere. They might put more laws and stipulations on it, but I think it's not going nowhere. And I hope you know y'all being watched. I'm being watched. Everyone is being watched. They know where y'all at. They can trace your IP address. I don't care if you got a VPN, you got all this bias protection, that don't mean shit. They can find you if they want to. So I encourage y'all to get y'all shit together, because it's not working. Y'all probably say, who the fuck is you? Who gave you the right to be a dick? The dictator and the orchestrator of the black race. Nobody. I'm just one of many. And I'm rare. I'm a rare breed of black men. Some of us is on YouTube, but not that many. Because a lot of black men deal in dungery and dysfunctional activity with their dialogue and their publications, so as women too. So, sister, I appreciate that. And I told y'all, the ones that really love my commentary and love my videos, feel free to address those trolls. Feel free to explain to those people who comment derogatory statements in my comment thread, to explain to them about my videos, because some of y'all get it. And I'm glad y'all getting it. I'm glad y'all putting the puzzle together and understanding what I'm talking about. Educate these people, because they lack wisdom. I'm here to wake up the sleeping giants and wake up the dead minds of some of us. But some of us can't be woke up. Those gonna be the ones. Unfortunately, it's gonna be too late. They're gonna try to wake up, but the door gonna be closed on them because they ain't take heed. This shit is escalating, folks. The prophecies are turning in the books, and y'all don't even see it. I never thought I'd see the day black people go backwards instead of forwards. We going back. Don't throw dirt, more dirt on the civil rights leaders' graves. They turning in their graves now. Martin Luther King, Mega Evers, all the freedom fighters back in the days who fought for our freedom. And this generation, my generation, and the young generation, those people did not die in vain. They made their mark. They made history. They was heroes. The women and the men, make them feel proud. Learn the legacy. They fought. Them hoses, them dolls, those whips, hangings, decapitations, guillotines, all that shit. That's why we're a strong people. And hell yeah, we the true Hebrews. And this is why the enemy don't want us to get our throne back. Don't y'all know this? How long does it take for us to wake up? Don't y'all know that we come from the first? Huh? I don't need to say the rest of it, because y'all already know what it is. Black Lives Matter is a bunch of bullshit. It is, because it don't serve a purpose. All lives matter. Humanity matters. The Most High matters. That's who matters. The doctrines, the laws, the things he instituted in the prophets. So he can give us a blueprint. And we ain't following the blueprint. So if we don't follow the Most High's blueprint and portfolio of righteousness and faith and laws in the court of the Most High's court, not the man's court of law, God's court of law. If we don't follow his rules, everything else is chaos. And that's what it's going on now. That's what's going on now. As I draw this Toby right here, this Sagato, I thank you, God, for giving me the forethought and the fruition to do this video, to spread love to my melanated people and my Anglo people and every nationality and ethnicity abroad. Thank you, Lord, because it needs to be addressed. We sitting around here in the devil's institution. And don't even know it, some of us. Bathing in hell, bathing in the fire of the brimstone, and don't even know it. So I don't want to put too much on y'all mind. It's something I was thinking about early this morning. Thank you, sis. That's what I mean. And y'all want to throw all black women under the bus? We got some good sisters out here. I don't even know the sister. I just know she subscribed to my channel, and she leaves lovely comments, and she defended me and was trying to explain to this other woman, he's not like that. And I'm not. I love black people. Even love the evil ones too, because they fools, and I pray for them. Think about it, y'all. Just think about it. Watch the whole video, please, before comment. King Roster. Good day. Good day.